this writing, it seems to be pointing to something nearby. More propaganda. Work hard to fight cold and hunger. Cocos of Nessia, the astronomer.
A prophet must have his followers. Cocos of Nicaea was one of the prophets first, branded a heretic in his home city. Cocos joined the pilgrimage north. His knowledge of the stars helped guide the way. It is said that Cocos and the prophet would sit for hours under the stars debating the nature of the universe and man's fraught place within it. For the prophet, he built an orrery, a of planets and stars, so that even during the dark of winter, he might gaze upon the night sky.
You've been the first to light a star of progress.
Huh.
In praise of cosmonauts. Communication repeaters. Trinity must have installed these. Family photograph. Russian, late 1950s. Perhaps one of them was imprisoned here. Something's written here. Remember. Intricate clockwork toy, made of bits of scrap metal and other detritus, all from the gulag. Must have taken a long time to gather the parts. Thank you. Just markings. They're not Russian. Warning, maybe? Executed, and so were his followers. Looks like this was abandoned in a hurry. Did the Soviets find something down there? There's water down below. Sounds like a great volume. Coin with an image of a city stamped in gold. And there's the prophet. This was likely an official coin of Katesh. Its icon, cast in gold. The metal workers of the city started to develop their own style, but it's still similar to Byzantine craftwork. That's got to be part of the works. Here we go. Works. water's eroding everything. At this rate, there won't be much left in a few decades. It's a cistern. Holding water back. On the wall. The levels change. Be able to swim through now. This should be more than enough oil to light the passages below, but be careful transporting it. We have not perfected the refining process, and it is still volatile.
You will know the man who supervises the construction. We all do. Without his knowledge of the Earth, none of us would have survived along the difficult journey. Do not linger. And if he asks for word of his wife and child, feign ignorance. He cannot accept that they perished during our exodus, and expects them to arrive any day. We need his genius, and I fear if he saw the truth, we might lose him entirely.
Another barrier. But how can I get to this one? Gifts of the Earth. that down yet. Maybe there's a way to get up to the old prison.
Thank you. The transmitter's destroyed?
The repeaters are offline. It's done.
So it is. We don't have much to spare, but if you're fighting with us, you can use this.
Maybe I can find Constantine's prisoner. He must know something. Gulag identification card for one of the prisoners. Someone scratched something below. Directions to something hidden. Soviet propaganda. Over completely.
I'm on your side here. I've been working as a maintenance tech for Trinity out here, but I've got to get out of here. These people are insane. I've been stockpiling gear. It's yours, if you can pay for it. They won't notice a few missing items, but if they catch wind, or if they see me with you, I'm a dead man. I'll need some untraceable currency in case things go south. Gold, preferably. You think we can make a deal?
I'll see what I can dig up.
It's not nukes. Creepy-looking guy with a scarred face named Constantine gave us a big speech, talked about destiny in something called the Source. And frankly, I'm even more baffled. The other contractors seem to be just as antsy and nervous as I am. But the company men? The guys who've been with Trinity for a long time? They're drinking it up and asking for seconds. It's fucking Jonestown out here. We're preparing for an assault. Against who, you might ask? I mean, there's people here, like natives, lost in time. We're talking furs, skins, and iron arrowheads. We're about to go meet them with attack choppers and 50 cal machine guns. I'm on the wrong goddamn side of history.